years, 2005, 2006. Now we have over 340 wind turbines operating in Lithuania. And climate change is one of the main topics in TV, media, in energy conferences, economic forums, and in our homes. And I'm very glad to be part of this movement which triggered it, which is now called the energy transition. And I'm very happy to see more and more people getting involved in wind and solar business, in other green businesses, in green technology, e-mobility, and other means of mitigating climate change. And I'm especially happy that we managed to convince our policymakers that the clean way forward is the only way forward. So now when I go to the other countries, I can proudly repeat that Lithuania is a country which is aiming for 100% renewables in electricity and in heating. And this makes my heart sing. And I know that in this room there are some people who are the true engineers of this change that happened, of this transition. And if you are sitting here, so you must be also proud to be part of this. One of those people is our well-respected Minister of Energy, Žygimantas Vaičiūnas. So Minister, please give us a round of applause before we go.
As well as for Aistis, Radavicius, and CEO of Wind Europe, Giles Dixon. So with your participation, this is really the things could be changed in a positive manner. So today and tomorrow we are here to listen the voice of renewables in the literal way. Because I would like to transmit the message that, of course, the government is open to the voice and open to change policy in the positive manner. And to listen what is done in a good manner, to listen what could be improved, that we could have the best legislation and the best environment for the development of renewables. And that's fact that wind is blowing in Lithuania. But from the government perspective, we are trying to do everything that legislative and regulatory wind also would be blowing to the right direction and without any disturbances. So today we have three key messages. First of all, we have clear ambition and clear vision for the development of renewables. And we will see that from the both perspective, from the onshore and the offshore wind development, because today we are talking about the development of renewables, but the wind energy in particular. The second message is, of course, the openness, our openness to the Lithuanian government and the Lithuanian framework, openness for the investments. And we really have some facts which prove that. The last but not the least, the necessity of the cooperation between the, all the stakeholders. And this conference is particularly a good momentum to talk about this cooperation, what could be done to have the best possible cooperation between the stakeholders. because in the development of the renewables, this wind mission is not possible just talking about one or another stakeholder. This is cooperative action. And to make an example, I would echo that yesterday, the Lithuanian Energy Agency presented the analysis, the assessment, how our municipalities are behaving, what are the progress on the approach towards the development of renewables and energy efficiency. So this was the first time when the Lithuanian, the actions of municipalities were evaluated. I'm really thankful for the Lithuanian Energy Agency. Of course, this is the first step, but this is also some interesting points to assess and to see some practical things. For example, the taxes for the property and so on. What is, how the municipalities are behaving? Because we can talk about nice things about the development and going forward in the implementation of the Green Deal, but the key actions is in the hands of the municipalities. So here I would like to turn to some of the concrete things about the government view, and maybe some things to repeat once again, but just to start this conference with a content-wise picture. So this is an old graph, but the same message that till 2050 we have 100 generation of renewables in our electricity. And of course this is from the Lithuanian energy strategy, these numbers, but this was also transmitted to our national energy and climate plan, which was submitted to the European Commission just at the last days of 2019. And the message is very clear that we have quite an interesting and particular situation that our energy import, electricity import, is really huge, about 70% of import. So this is the good place and the good starting point to invest into renewables and to change this picture to the positive kind. We have more generation domestic indigenous energy generation here. So until 2030, at least half or 45% renewables in final energy consumption, as well as in electricity consumption. But I'm saying very clearly, this is at least, because after the evaluation of National Energy and Climate Plan, we see that this is the minimum or conservative approach towards the development of renewables. So what is the status quo? Of course, it will be more presentation today, but we have the picture that we have more than 500 megawatts installed wind power capacity, more than 200 units. And of course, the wind energy is the major source of electricity generation. So this is the fact. And we achieved our renewables target for 2020 already in 2014. Of course, this was the reason for us to go forward and to sell the statistics, which was the first statistical transfer agreement with Luxembourg. I'm here to say that the system is working practically, and the statistics was transferred for 2018, and I'm moving forward. So the system is functioning. What is our target for renewables development till 2030? I should say three main numbers. Let's talk about the numbers and the megawatts. So first of all, it's about talking about the large scale auctions, and we had the first one this year. And the results was here in the middle of January. So talking about the large scale auctions, we are planning in the next 3-4 years to have additional 500 megawatts capacity. This is rough calculation because we have to. Concerning the level playing field and technological neutrality, we are speaking about 2.5 terawatt hours. So this is the double the capacity what we have now. And so it means that at the end we could have about 1,000 megawatts more wind in case it would be wind or another technology. For the small scale, for the prosumers, I'm happy to see the development on our frameworks and also supporting with our parliament on installing the virtual power plant, the one of the first in Europe. And this week, by the way, is the end for the consumers to apply for the financing support. About 30% of the solar panels will be supported from the state, and we have this really popular, this scheme is very popular. More than 5,000 consumers, individual consumers, already applied, and still we have some time to the end of the week. And this will be the double the capacity what we have last year. Currently we have about 130 megawatts of solar installed solar panels. This is together the industry and individual consumers, and about 30 megawatts is consumers, individual consumers also in the industry. Last but not the least, the offshore wind. Offshore wind is included in our national energy and climate plan. And this is really the case that in 2030 we are expecting to have 700 megawatts capacity of installed wind offshore. So you can see that the biggest development, the biggest game changer will be the offshore wind development in Lithuania. But to sum up, of course, it's, the main message is talking about the large scale generation where the wind power has the really competitive advantage. But also, it's very important to talk about the small scale prosumers. And you know that Lithuania has, on Baltic states, just 30 years ago, the so called singing revolution. And I do believe that this year also will be the shining revolution for the Lithuania, shining revolution for the installation of the solar power plants. So just some details about the renewable options. It was our view that for the investors it's very important to see the clarity and to see the plans, not only the numbers but also the concrete plans on each of the year. So as I said, the test or the pilot option was held in September. The results was just in the middle of January. We are happy to see that this option was really competitive. The competition was very tight, and it means that the market was waiting for this step. And the winner, of course, was declared, and it's very clear that it was commitment to develop wind energy without any of the state support. So that's a good momentum for the development, not only for the wind energy, because we have really a competitive environment and participation, not only from the wind power, but also from solar and biogas projects, which are competing for this pilot option. The good news is that we have the continuity of the options. The next option will be organized after a couple of months in May this year, and then every year the single option. So to sum up, we'll have 2.5 terawatt hours after 3-4 years after the development of the system. So we are not stopping here. The scheme and the megawatts is, or the terawatt hours is the, not the message. So we are improving the system, and I'm happy to say that the support of our parliament now in the final stages of discussion the change of the renewable energy law, which will include three main positive changes. So it will be the possibility to have the power purchase agreements without additional license. So every single producer of the wind power will have the possibility to sell energy, and this will not be additional requirements. Also guarantee of origins for auction winners of market projects, and last but not the least, the financial compensation. Once in case there are supply disruptions or interruption, and in case the transmission system or operator have to have some changes. So this is very clear numbers, very clear calculation, what will be the compensation system. And today I'm just currently, the Vice Minister Aistis is in the Parliament finalizing the discussions in the committees. So we hope that this law will be adopted just at the first weeks of the new Parliament session, which will start in the 10th of March. So, and it would mean that the PPAs and guarantees of origin scheme will be valid, will be possible to prevent from June this year. And compensation, financial compensation scheme will be available, will be legally possible from July this year. So it means that for the development of for the market participants, this is clear that we have a new positive framework. Well, talking about the offshore wind potential, I'm really glad to say that the offshore wind is included in our National Energy and Climate Plan. Of course, it was a good ideas from the Europe that this should be included, and we listened to these messages, we opened to the market, as I said before, and this was included, and we see that, that really we can develop the offshore wind farms till 2030. The potential is 3.4 gigawatts, and I'm happy also to see that after the evaluation of the Wind Europe, Lithuanian offshore territory has the lowest potential on the price levels. I mean that to invest here in the objective situation we see and in the framework, this is the levelized cost of energy. Is really one of the lowest in the world we've seen. And what are the key milestones for this year and for the next months? We are planning to the government to have very clear resolution on the next step developing the wind, offshore wind energy. So it means that we are planning to approve the all the system, how the auction for 700 megawatts will be organized. We are planning to have this option in 2023 or 2022. But as I said, for the investors, the clarity is the of the utmost importance. This is the reason why in the next months we are planning, after the discussion with the market, to prepare and to approve this on the government level. And finalizing this, I'm really delighted to see that that we gathered here in Vilnius to discuss and to enhance, exchange your best experience, and really for creating better Europe, for creating better tomorrow, and really to do all the practical things that we are not talking about the mission, but we are talking about the practical ways how to benefit and how to be the part of the European Green Deal with creating the best possible environment for the world of energy. So all the success, have a good exchange of experiences, and I do believe that this conference this event really will get the results in the forthcoming future. Thank you.